Hey Roadrunners, it's Friday, April 14th. On today's show we have
A Man on the Street,
an interview with CJSF about the dance,
a skit on state testing,
and we're on this week's Roadrunner Report. Are you going to the dance?
I'm still thinking about going or not.
Well, we asked the Roadrunners whether they're going or not and what they're wearing.
Hey, my name is Lamont. I'm here with
Giancarlo,
Davina,
Liliana.
And the question of the day is, are you going to the dance? And if so, what are you wearing?
I don't know yet.
No.
I'll probably just wear sweats.
Okay. Hey, my name is Lamont. I'm here with
Pepe,
Gamal,
Luis.
And the question of the day is, are you going to the dance? And if so, what are you wearing?
What I'm wearing? Might be going to dance if I'm wearing. Oh, you don't know what I'm wearing. I'm going to be wearing short shorts with the long baggy sleeves with the biggest hat I could find out there.
I'm not going to the dance.
Yeah, I'm going to the dance. I'm probably just going to wear something like the Hawaiian t-shirts. Just like palm trees all around them.
Okay, thank you. Hey, my name is Juan. I'm here with
Henzo.
And the question of the day is, are you going to the dance? And if so, what are you wearing?
A skirt.
A skirt? Hey, my name is Lamont. I'm here with
Alexandria,
Nicole,
Alana,
Emily.
And the question of the day is, are you going to the dance? And if so, what are you wearing?
No, I'm not going.
For sure not.
I'm not going.
I'm going, and I'm going to wear a super cute white dress. Duh.
Hey, my name is Lamont. I'm here with
Myrie.
And the question of the day is, are you going to the dance?
Yes.
What are you wearing?
I might wear a dress. I don't know what type of dress, though.
Okay. Hey, my name is Lamont. I'm here with
Zoe,
Lulu.
And the question of the day is, are you going to the dance? And if so, what are you wearing?
Yeah, I'm going to go, but I don't know what I'm wearing yet.
Yeah, I'm going, and I'm wearing regular
Okay.
Have you seen the new campus supervisor?
Yes, but I don't know much about him other than the fact that he's a new supervisor.
Well, lucky for you, we had a short interview with him.
Let's cut to the clip.
Hey, my name is Lamont. I'm here with
John, the new campus supervisor.
And the question of the day is, how do you feel about Prescott?
It's cool. I like it. It's better than other schools I've been to, so it's a nice environment.
How do you like the kids?
They're cool. Some of them are better than others, but I like them all.
Okay, thank you.
Did you hear this dance today?
Yeah, but I had some questions about it.
Well, we interviewed Ms. Faria about the dance.
Let's dance to the clip.
Hi there, I'm Christina, and I'm here with
Ms. Faria.
And we're going to ask her a few questions about a dance that's about to come up. When is the dance?
The dance is actually tonight from 6 to 8.
How much do the tickets cost?
Well, at the door, they're going to be $6. But if you were smart and bought it in advance, which you still can do at both lunches today, it's $5.
Okay. What theme is the dance?
The dance is Hawaiian, luau, tropical theme, whatever desires.
Where is the money from the dance going to?
The money for the dance goes to the 7th grade CJSF group, and it is going to go towards our field trip, which they are earning to go to the beach boardwalk.
Is there a money goal?
Is there a money goal? Well, we usually break about $1,000, so that's what at least our goal is, and anything over always helps.
What is the dress code for the dance?
Dress code is, well, we're doing the Hawaiian theme, but you always still have to follow the dress code in the planner. So if you're not sure about dress code, check your planners.
Are there rules for the dance?
Rules for the dance, well, same rules that would be in your planner, because this is a school activity, and cell phones will need to be left in, leave it at home, best place, but otherwise you'll be putting all your personal items in your PE locker.
Well, thank you for your time.
Well, thank you. Have fun at the dance, everybody. See you there.
Yay!
Hi there. I'm here to talk about the upcoming state tests and how to prepare for them. I know mostly none of you want to take the state test. Trust me, I don't either. They are, however, very important to take in order for teachers and the state to know what level of education you are at. It is important to make sure you try your hardest on these tests as they drive a lot of classes that will be picked out for you and for you to pick out later into high school. That's why I'm here to give you tips in order to do your best on the state test. Number 1. Sleep. Sleep drives a lot of our choices. Like how some people get grumpy if they don't get the right amount of sleep, or some do worse with too much sleep. It is relevant to know what amount of sleep is right for you, so you can do your best on the tests with the right amount of sleep that is best for you. Number 2. Nutrition. It is important to have a good breakfast on days of testing. A good meal can range from a feast to a little breakfast for people, as everyone is different. It is also good to bring water with you so you can keep hydrated and keep everything flowing in your body. Bring a snack with you to school just in case you are still hungry and need to eat something during the early morning of school or AM break. Number 3. Studying. I know mostly everyone says, study for your upcoming tests so you can get a good grade. It can get pretty annoying, especially if you are trying your best, but sometimes it just doesn't feel good enough. Everyone's been there once, but it is still important to study. Doing your best on the test can show the state what you need to work on and will tell them that you are trying by getting better over time. Also, make sure that you don't overdo the studying, like staying up late at night till 2 a.m. just studying. It can ruin how you do in the test, so make sure you have a time of the day to study and when to end the studying session. You can also make study sessions with friends. Those are overall the three main parts of getting ready for the state test or any test overall. There are many other things and people that help you feel ready for your upcoming tests, like environment, social life, friends, etc. I wish you all luck in the state testing. By Roadrunners.
Have you ever had your shoes authenticated?
No, but I heard there's someone at school who does it.
Well, we interviewed Joseph and Leo on what it's like to authenticate shoes.
Let's run to the clip.
Hey out there, Roadrunners, it's Mr. Coxford. I am here today with Joseph Enwia, seventh grader, seventh grade businessman. Bet you didn't know that about him. You knew he was a great wrestler and great student and all that, but guess what? There's more to this guy than meets the eye. Check this out. This guy, Joe, he's a sneaker authenticator. Yeah, you heard that right, and he makes money at it. So this has caught my attention in class because he told me that he did this. And I think you would be interested to know exactly what he does to make some money. All right, so Joe, tell me what a sneaker authenticator does.
So basically, there's like certain shoes that are like, they're more high end than most shoes. So basically what people do, they'll bring it to sneaker authenticators to make sure they're real, especially if they want to sell them. So that's basically what we do. We just make sure that they're real.
Oh, I get it. So like if I had like the first generation of like Air Jordans or something and I wanted to get my money's worth for it, I would come to you and say, how much are these Air Jordans worth? These
yeah.
like original Air Jordans, brand new. How much would something like that be worth? It was like the original issue in the 1980s of like Air Jordan shoes in good condition.
So it honestly depends on the condition. So if you had like a good condition, like 1985 original pair, it can go anywhere from like $5,000 to $15,000.
Are you kidding me? $5,000 to $15,000 for a pair of shoes from 1985?
Yeah.
Why didn't I buy like 20 pairs of those back then? Nah, I didn't keep them this long. Why? Too late for that now.
Yeah.
Anyway, so tell me some things. Like, what are some of the shoes that you've authenticated that were worth the most money?
So one of the most expensive pairs I've like handled was a pair. They're not released yet. They're only a few of them. They're called the Yellow Lobsters. I've only held them once, and they sent me pictures of them to authenticate them because they didn't want to send them to me. So yeah, that was probably the most expensive pair. It's about 60 grand.
60 grand for a pair of shoes?
Yeah.
Yellow Lobsters.
Yeah.
And are they like, but they're like athletic kind of shoes or what? When do you use them? Or just wear them?
Yeah, just like, you just wear them.
Okay. I will not be getting a pair of yellow lobsters. And right now, Chloe's showing me a pair of yellow lobsters. The Nikes, okay. All right, I will not be buying those anytime soon. Let's say they send you the shoes, like they won't send you the yellow lobsters because they're way too expensive, but they send you an expensive pair. They trust you that you're gonna send them back. But you, once you authenticate them, you get a cut of that money. Like you, they give you money for doing that. How much do you earn personally?
So it honestly depends on the price of the shoe. I get a percentage of how much it's worth.
Yeah.
So if a pair is, so like, there's different companies that I can work for. There's one called the Legit App.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes Goat sends me shoes, even though like they say they're not from Goat, but they are, because mm-hmm. it comes with all like their authentication stuff that I can prove that it's authenticated.
Okay.
But wait, what was
like how much money do you get? Like $50, $100, or
so?
Like,
yeah. Say a pair of shoes was worth like $300. I get like $15 to $20 from that just to authenticate it. But if it's like more on the high end, like $1,000 or more than that, mm-hmm. I get like 50 to up in the hundreds.
Okay, so how much does that equal like in a month? Like you probably don't do this every single day, you get it once in a while. Would you say monthly, how much would you make in this job?
I can make a few $100.
Okay, not bad. That's actually some good money. What are you wearing today? You got some sneakers on that you wanna share with us? And how you
take them off?
Yeah, take them off.
All right.
Well, should you take them off? I mean,
okay, they're fine.
Yeah. He's gonna show us this and also how to authenticate. So,
So this is a pair of Travis Scott Reverse Mochas. Right now they're sitting at like $1,200.
For this?
For these, yeah.
Okay, thank you. Just kidding. Okay, so $1,200, all right, that's more than I've paid for any shoe. Ever?
These are a little bit different the way we authenticate them. So mainly I'm just gonna take a look at this shoe real quick. I can tell by the colors mm-hmm. that they're good. And I'm gonna look right here. I don't know if you can see it. There's these three stitching lines. Those are bigger than these.
Yes.
And it's also up here. It's bigger than that. That's a good sign.
Oh.
And I'm gonna take the insole out, actually.
Okay. Oh god, it's coming out. Don't tear it.
Nah, it's not. I've taken it out.
He's got this. He's a professional.
Wait, I think I gotta take it out on
the other one.
Shoe.
Yeah, we can do that. I'll hold this one for you. $1,200.
It's not want to come out.
Doesn't want to come out. That's okay. The insoles, we don't want to, you know, tear anything or reduce the value of this.
But basically what I can check from underneath the insole mm-hmm. is there's lines of glue on the bottom of the insole.
Okay.
I think that one might come out. Let me just try one more time so I can show you guys.
The insole actually does say Travis Scott.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's fine if
it's coming out.
Yeah.
All right. You sure? Oh.
Okay, no, that's
he just tore them. They're now worth $200.
Okay, that's fine though.
That's okay.
So there's lines of stitching in there that I can check to see if they're real. If I wanted to take it out, I'd have to use like a hairdryer or something.
Oh yeah.
But yeah.
But these are a pair that you want to wear personally. You don't plan on selling them. This is so it doesn't really matter. It's like not for sale. So.
And if I check here, there's like Cactus Jack. It said it shouldn't go past this line, and if it does, that will probably get called fake. A lot of people will call you out.
Oh, really?
And stuff, yeah.
I don't know if you guys can see that. It does say Cactus Jack right there. I don't know if you can see that, but so that is a watermark or something that has to be there in order to be real. Okay.
One of my final ways, if like. We usually check the box too, but if they don't come with the box, we'll just use a black light on them.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll check the entire shoe for any markings. I don't know if like it's hard to see in here because of the light, but there's no like pen marks or anything like that across the shoe.
Mm-hmm.
So I would say these are real, but
they look real to me.
Yeah,
Cactus Jacks are on there, so.
And another way is...
What about this right here? Can you tell me how much this might be worth? This is a Hoka 1-1 Bondi 7 running shoe. Can you tell me if it's genuine and how much it might be worth?
I think they're good.
Okay. Yeah.
I have no clue how much those would be worth.
It's got custom orthotics inside.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Only fits me though, so probably best I just wear it, not try to sell it.
Yeah.
This one. I might not
get
much
worth
money
like
for this.
$30
maybe.
$30. Yeah.
I'm just gonna keep 20? On. I'm gonna put it right back on my foot. It's not for sale. For those of you who are hoping to buy it.
Toast?
Anyway, so this is pretty awesome. Now, where do you see yourself going with this? I wouldn't say hobby. It's like your side hustle. It's like,
yeah.
What do you have aspirations for? Starting a bigger business of this sort, or where do you see yourself doing this, like in 5 years, let's say?
I could see myself still doing it.
Yeah.
I think it still won't be as big because people. They have like a lot of cheaper, they do it for a lot cheaper, but those are just people that don't, like, they're not
like you.
No.
No, they're amateurs.
Yeah.
As opposed to professional.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I think you're gonna be in demand for a while because you have the knowledge of what these shoes should look like, as opposed to these wannabes that are trying to cut in on your gig here. So I think you've got a advantage.
Yeah.
So, well, good. If you roadrunners, yeah, interested in this kind of a thing, you know, you might want to do some research on it. I found it to be a unique job or unique side hustle, and I think you have the entrepreneurial spirit to be a very good business person in the future. So, congratulations on that, and keep making that money. All right. Bye, roadrunners. Hope you enjoy this, and we'll see you next time. Bye bye.
One person, bring me the food coloring box. And you're gonna have one person go up and get paper towels from the sink.
Three jokes, you know. What do you call a blind dinosaur? Do you think he's saurus? Why don't puddles ever laugh at your jokes? They don't like dry humor.
What?
What did the big flower say to the little flower? Hey there, bud.
Mr. Cox said laugh. Laugh.
Ha ha.
Ha 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 ha. Laugh. Laugh.
Hey, Roadrunners, just want to give a quick shout out to all of the NHD participants this weekend. If you see these students, give them a high five and wish them good luck for the weekend. Shout out to Angelina, Winter, Sophia, Hassan, Emily, Aditya, Rudra, Emma, Brooklyn, and I think that's it. Good luck.
Thanks for watching this week's show.
Have a great time at the dance tonight. Bye,
Bye Roadrunners.
Shout out to Miss Maria!
Feliz cumpleaños!
We love you! Yeah!
Yippee! do you hear? Hear? No. Okay.
Jordan, do you hear the ocean?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Maybe.
It might just be the Hawaiian luau dance. This Friday, today, tonight, 6 o'clock. Be there or be square.
I'm from Co-op City, and my partner here is...
We're all from Co-op City.
Yeah, it was a great time in Co-op City, not gonna lie. I would go back, but...
Too many...
Hopefully you're not recording this, because...
Did I do that?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it did.
How'd you win first try?
Either, bud. All right. Goodbye.
I won. I'm better.